This looks... I look weird in the red. Ball. Always going
up. It's mostly the t-shirt everything's that really backwards. Makes it weird.
Yeah. Can you guys see this mirrored? Or is... Like, can you read this?
It's mirrored.
It's mirrored
now. Oh, so what we're... So what Roll20 does is mess with it.
Yes. The same way Skype does.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks.
You, you see it mirrored, but we see it straight.
God damn it. Mm-hmm.
So you probably can't tell I have a Zelda Princess Peach shirt.
I've actually got a Zelda shirt myself on, which you can't see, obviously.
Right. I'm here, but I'm going off.
I'm wearing a Space Boss hoodie, just FYI. Mm. And on it is a Serenity pin.
Ah. Because
that one I did get.
But
the package
hasn't
come yet.
I was going to show you the awesome Serenity t-shirt I got at Comic-Con.
Sick hacks.
Yeah, there we go.
I mean, that's the one advantage I see with living in America.
Yes.
Get Comic-Con.
Yes.
And PAX.
But yeah, this was Emerald City Comic-Con, not the big one in SCCC, but it's still it's a nice star field with the shadow of Serenity on it.
Still better than what we get.
Mm. My loot crate has arrived, Firefly, but I don't think I'm going to show anything off because I don't want to spoil anything for Chikawa.
Hey, I met Alan Tudyk at Comic-Con in London. That was cool.
Right. That does sound cool.
Yes.
Yeah.
He sounds like
really does. Con Man, or whatever that is. Is that
yeah, right.
Yeah.
I still need to watch that.
So do I.
So-so has remembered that we're on Sunday today, which is good.
Nice.
Yes, and of course my autocorrect then insults So-so. Stupid ass autocorrect.
Autocorrect, making the world a little bit shittier.
Yeah. I like to call it auto-stupid.
Right, so we'll just do a very quick recap so we can fit as much of this in as possible.
Yep.
So, last time, you attempted to investigate the crime scene, only to find it had been scrubbed clean. Eliza lost a body. I have dropped that to a D8 as an extra day has passed, though as nobody's told you yet exactly what happened to the body.
You'd think it'd go up as days pass. She panics more.
No, at this point she's just drunk. She just starts drinking in the morning, just goes, no, I can't deal with this.
Welcome to my world.
Wu, in an epic moment of awesome, instead of having you traipse around looking for Shark Lip Shen, Wu challenged him directly and got an invite to meet him. You're now invited to his game. Wu is permitted an entourage of 3 additional people. That may be important for you later today. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, she is now known as Blackjack Blackie, a known cheat, and has a D10 complication for any roles she makes. Having met with Shark Lips, you did a bit of scouting at the casino, and on your return back to your suite in the evening, were assaulted by 4 thugs.
Ah, yes.
They were pretty quickly dispatched, particularly thanks to some epic kazoo playing, which was sadly not on the recording, as it cut out just after the fighters failed. And then Zaps doing a very impressive, if somewhat insane, attack that actually
never
worked
happened.
Out very well.
It never happened.
It was me.
There's no proof. So Zaps has not done anything combat worthy yet.
After you took out 3 of the goons, they decided that they'd sent their message and fled. You interrogated the one that was remaining, and discovered he was sent by somebody named Butch. And that is all you know. So we are now on the day of the Faro game. It will take place this evening at 8 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm giving you the day rather than jumping straight there in case you want to do any fact-finding or discover anything about any of the other players at the game, as thanks to Wu, you skipped meeting any of them.
I mean, like I was saying to Keith before we started, I love how the fact that what we did was we went and said, okay, so the sheriff told us about this guy that might have done it. Let's just go straight after him, fuck everything else. And we know nothing about anybody else who might or might not have a motive.
Hey,
whoa.
Is
Butch.
I've interrogated several people.
You've interrogated
the crime scene.
We spoke to the blacksmith.
Yeah.
That was it.
Mm-hmm. And we spoke to the sheriff. We spoke to several people asking, gee, do you know if she had any enemies? Most people said, no, we don't.
You did spend an awfully long time interrogating the dirty deputies.
That was Isaac who did that. Yeah.
I was lonely, right?
Lonely.
He misses Seth. Let's not tease him.
Okay, so we should probably go to some of those places we skipped and maybe try to meet people or something.
Like... Okay.
We should probably ask the sheriff about the other players.
I should actually grab my notes.
I was prepared. Mine are right here.
There we go. Let us have a peek.
I also noted down what our ship is called this episode because...
Thanks, because
otherwise I would have forgotten.
It's the Thunder something.
Thunder Stealer.
That's it, yes.
Right.
Yes. I was thinking we should probably go to one of the... We have not gone to the mid-range restaurant yet, I don't believe. And...
Well, you have been to the mid-range one. That was
the train one. How can you think about food right now?
It's lunchtime in the U.S.
Fair. Oh, yeah, it is.
Sorry, yeah, that's why my video may be going off. Sorry, it's lunchtime here. I'm kind of hungry.
Oh, that's fine.
It's just us, Keeb.
Yep.
It's just us.
Everybody else is eating.
What? I'm here.
No, we all know you're all here, but...
Oh,
you're the only one people can see.
Yes. Yeah, so...
Yeah, the last one we need to go to is Bunkhouse Vittles.
Yeah.
To get more food.
Let me just find who's actually hanging out at Bunkhouse Vittles.
Sure, I was keeping up tradition.
I wish I could see what that was.
It's passion fruit frozen yogurt.
Ooh, nice.
Yes.
Anyway, sorry, let's get some food in-game.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yep, I'm just going to find who is hanging out at Bunkhouse Vittles, if anybody.
What time is it in-game again?
We'll say it's 9 a.m. So you've got plenty of time.
Morning, the day off.
As long as
there's
coffee, I'm fine.
Yeah, let's go to the cheap joint.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see who's over there. Seps walks in, pulls up his nose a bit. It's like, ugh, God, not this place.
Oh yeah, that's way up the top.
We're gonna have to when we finish at some sort of mid-season midpoint or whatever in this, we're going to have to go back and redo all of the scenes that got cut from the various spots.
Yes.
Have a flashback episode, you mean?
Exactly, yeah.
We should probably note down what happened then.
Oh, we all know what happened, it's fine.
Actually, that reminds me, I should probably do a backup recording. Just in case.
Yeah.
Yep, it seems to be behaving itself today. So, I don't know.
Probably
we hope it's going to behave itself, but...
The old better safe than sorry. I do not need my camera here as well. There we go. Okay. Good.
Okay, so...
incriminating evidence here.
The bunkhouse. Yep. Is it just you guys, or are you going to meet the sheriff there for breakfast?
Have we... I can't remember. Did we speak to him last episode and be like, hi, we need the money to get in the game?
Yes.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, because he said that was how he was going to get you in. Unfortunately, he couldn't use casino funds, so he's given you the money that was
right, yeah.
Annie's evidence, and you mm-hmm. basically got to give it back because you haven't yet been able to prove that that was the money she was going to pay Wu.
I mean, that's going to be very
been
hard.
Willing
to
prove it yet, either. Because why cast more aspersions on our crew than the fact that I misplaced the body?
Right. So, I don't think we need to meet the sheriff there.
Because
actually, we do. He might know who else is in the game.
Like who else would know in the game?
That's a good point, actually.
Enabling me at this point.
So you're not going to meet the sheriff. That's fine.
We can do. What do the rest of you think?
I'm up for meeting the sheriff.
Meeting the sheriff.
Just because he'll be able to point out the person who's actually
exactly.
in Bunkhouse Vittles. Otherwise, you probably won't recognise her for who she actually is.
Oh, okay, yeah, good idea.
So, yeah, uh-oh. So you're having breakfast with the sheriff.
I think we'd be able to recognise a Sant B ourselves.
Yeah, it's not a Sant B. He does point out a lady in a very revealing dress. Says her name is Lula.
Okay.
Okay.
She apparently works for Colonel Baines. He doesn't eat in any of the restaurants. He eats in his room, but she comes down to collect his meals from the bunkhouse.
Sorry, could you repeat those names? Lula.
Yep.
Lula.
And
for...
Colonel Baines.
Is she in the game, or is...
Colonel Baines is one of the gamblers.
That's what
right.
I was going to say. She's his gopher.
Yeah.
No, PA.
Gopher. I've worked as a PA.
Yeah. Given the dress she's wearing, I believe she's also occasionally referred to as nurse, so...
Okay.
What?
She's his beard. That's what she is. She's his distraction.
Am I right envisioning a red sequined sexy nurse outfit?
Yeah, let's go for that.
Wait, in public?
Well, she's...
Yes?
The description is that she's dressed like a floozy.
I'd wear that in public.
Yeah, that works.
Sheriff Cow, feel free to pun away. I know you're mid-eating, which is why it's safe to mention it. He fills you in a little bit on Colonel Baines. Colonel Baines likes to... whenever he's out in public, he's always dressed in his Alliance military dress uniform.
The chances of these two saying anything are pretty small. I mean, Nav has dairy product in his mouth.
Yep. So, he was a high-ranking... Alliance military officer, believed to now be retired, and
believed to be.
We haven't got full details on him yet.
Okay.
He's mostly here for some free drinks and a chance to win some money.
Who isn't?
He's believed to be interested in playing with Shen, and has been seen there a few times. He is confined to a wheelchair, so yes, he must be retired. Lula wheels him round. That's why she's referred to as the nurse.
The nurse outfit, of course.
Yeah. So kind of imagine Hello Nurse from the Animaniacs, if you can remember that.
Yeah.
Kind of imagine Isaac's eyes bulging out, and then he collects himself, and he's like, hang on. I have rules.
Yeah. I was going to say, if you...
I just poke him in the ribs and say, no. Bad Isaac.
Hey, look, Rule number 7 is don't trust the help.
I was going to say, if you hadn't had the sheriff with you to point her out, I was just going to have her bump into Isaac.
Mia just looks at Isaac, rolls her eyes, and shakes.
Damn it! Can the crew for 5 seconds stop cock-blocking Isaac? Please?
No. I'm not cock-blocking you. You can go ahead.
He just disapproved, that's all.
Look, so I may be going through some things. I'm trying to get over Seth, all right? Just, you know, bear with me on this. It's a journey I'm on.
It's a journey you're on with every single floozy in this town.
Yeah. So,
hey,
was there anything else?
You have your coping mechanisms. I've got mine.
Was there anything else you wanted to know about Lula or the Colonel?
How were they related to the victim?
There doesn't appear to be any relation. They're just known to attend the game.
I should write down the victim's name, actually.
What kind of class of high roller is Colonel
Foy? Boy.
I wrote it down.
Yeah.
So seriously, I mean, Colonel Baines obviously is not poor, but how high of a roller is he? How much are we looking to have him be here?
I mean, he's easily matching the stakes of this game. He seems to lose a lot, but seems to still have a lot of money. Nobody's quite sure where it's coming from.
I don't know how I can keep doing this, because there's a guy called... I'm going to forget his name is Baines and incessantly refer to him as Colonel Mustard. I can't, like...
Go ahead!
I'll join you on this journey.
I'll
join you on it.
With Lula, we've basically got Miss Scarlet, so...
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so we have Miss Scarlet and Colonel Mustard.
So yes, Miss Scarlet is in the queue getting some food for the Colonel.
Who's Professor White?
No, he's Colonel Mustard.
It's Reverend White and Professor Plum.
Yeah.
Yes.
White is the maid.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This is Clue Red.
Or Clue Red.
Oh, right.
So yeah, so she's there if anybody wants to chat to her.
Well, Isaac, go ahead.
Hang on, is she with the Colonel?
No, he eats in his room. He doesn't come down. She goes and fetches the food for him.
If she's not part of the game, then I don't know that we can get anything from her. But actually, before I do anything else, Keeve, Cortex look up.
Yep. On both of them?
If I can get a picture of him, or if I can look up his name, yeah, sure.
Yep, Colonel Ambrose...
I've got his facial recognition.
Yep, Colonel Ambrose Baines.
Ambrose Baines.
Yep.
Okay.
He was an officer who served with distinction during the war. Mm-hmm. He retired early, potentially been living on a government pension ever since. A large portion
record?
Of his war record is sealed.
Ooh. Well, that's not that unusual.
Sealed by whom?
The Alliance.
Yep.
They have lots of things they don't want us to know.
You might have clearance to unseal it, but it will take a little while to get you that information.
Wait, what? We might be able to get that clearance?
Isaac
he
might.
Might not. I might.
The rest of you don't know that.
It's got a superpower, so it's Google Glass.
Yeah.
Stop getting all suspicious, it's not a big deal.
No, I was going to say, we know that Isaac might have this power.
Yeah.
Because he was referring to... And this is a callback to the first episode... When you dug a hole.
Yes.
That was different. That was all Zaps.
Yeah, but it was also you.
Yeah. Well, anyway. I mean, as far as you know, I was an ordinary Alliance soldier. Nothing special. As far as I know.
Your look up on Lula based on the face recognition.
Yes.
You know that her surname is Burton. Lula Burton.
Okay.
Information on her is incredibly sparse.
Keeb, last time I had incredibly sparse information on someone, it was Asante.
No, that was last time you had no information.
That's true.
No, it's not true. We had some information.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's basic documents and history, but...
Okay, right. So I've got, like, a vague... Does it say what her previous, employment or anything, or just anything about her part before she got here?
Nope.
Okay. Isaac is remembering Rule 7. The Colonel has a sealed record. I will actually put in a request to have that made available, but just quickly as a low priority.
Yeah. Okay. Anything else you want to know from the sheriff?
Anyone?
Who's Butch?
Butch.
What can you tell us about him?
Yep, glad you asked.
Oh yeah, he will know who Butch is, and we
He says if you want to meet Butch, you can meet him on the casino floor. He's usually hanging around there. Took Cow a little while to uncover his actual name. He goes by Butch. No, it is not. It is a Chinese surname that I cannot pronounce, so I will type his full name into chat.
I'm not having the chips argument.
Major Beauregard Guiying.
Beauregard.
Beauregard Guiying.
Guiying.
Guiying. Yeah. So, Butch.
Yeah, let's go on Butch, it's easier.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah,
I agree.
It took Cow a little while to learn that name. For obvious reasons, he's just Butch. He was a brown coat. For the independence movement. But he's basically not a very nice piece of work. He's a mercenary. Believed to be involved in minor arms trade. Basically, he's very, very rich from the mercenary business, and is looking to earn some money playing cards.
And he doesn't want us involved?
Does he know Tempton Steel at all? Being a minor arms dealer?
No, because he's Templeton did most of his business with the Alliance.
Oh, okay.
Although he did sell some stuff to the Browncoats.
Huh. Wait a second. Does it mean that these two are in a way rivals right now?
Say what?
Is Butch and
Steel
Colonel Mustard
business right now?
Well, Steel is an arms manufacturer.
Oh, right.
Butch on the arms side is very much small time.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so much for using that angle.
Yeah.
Question, is there a brown coat high command thing, just like there's an Alliance command?
Not really.
If it still exists, it's probably not accessible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Think of the Brown Courts more as rebels, kind of.
Yeah, they had a support structure and everything, so...
Mm.
10 years ago.
They probably broke it down.
And these things broke.
I could imagine them basically to wiping the record to keep their people safe.
I could also see the Alliance dismantling anything that was left.
Yeah.
Forcibly.
I mean, sure.
But yeah, from what you are able to glean about him, because I assume Isaac is doing a look-up as soon as he gets the name.
Yes.
It's believed his unit was active at the Battle of Serenity Valley, and it's believed they operated quite far behind enemy lines, And there's a lot of rumours of looting and other stuff following their path through.
I don't like him.
Question. Might I have encountered him in my work as a brown coat?
Were you at Serenity Valley?
No, but he did not start at Serenity Valley.
He started on Hera. How you pronounce that one?
Serenity Valley. Is that the battle?
That's the last battle.
Shut up about.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's the last battle.
Oh yeah, that is where Serenity Valley was. So yes.
Yeah.
Gabe, is this someone I would have encountered in my journeys?
It's highly likely. He was one of those who gained somewhat of a reputation.
Don't know if I can place him, though.
Yeah.
Right, and I'm back in the room. Okay, so we've got... That's three people of note.
Mm-hmm.
That is...
What is Butcher's connection to Anna?
Lulu.
No known connection.
Again, the Faro game is the connecting point.
The Faro game is going to be what connects all of these people, I'm afraid.
I wonder why he wanted us to have the game then.
He wants to win it for some reason?
Wait, if you wanted us out of the game, was...
Blackjack Blackie, you know what I mean.
Was Annie going to be in the game?
No, Annie would have been staff at the game.
Oh.
Staff? Weird. Just to look
well,
good?
Yeah, because she's on the casino payroll. She's entertainment.
Right.
Okay.
And right. Lacking motive.
we'll have to establish that.
Yep. And there's quite a fun mechanic for doing this. Sheriff also gives you a little bit of information about two other people. Obviously, he's given you a little bit of information about Sharklip.
Right.
You know he's linked to the Triads and is basically using this game as a way of accumulating funds. Unfortunately, Cal hasn't got enough proof to do anything, and when he does get enough proof, the casino basically asks him to look the other way, because he's good for business for them, really.
Mm.
Right.
Interesting. Is there anything on what Shen did during the Unification Wars?
There's no information. It looks like he tried to steer clear of the fighting as much as possible.
Makes sense.
Smart man.
And the last person you have some information on is Big Cassie.
Ooh.
Okay.
Go on.
I was not clicked in the right thing. Cassia Pierce Sierra, or Big Cassie.
Okay.
She cuts.
Cassia Pierce.
Yeah. Okay. Yep, she is a big lady, as evidenced by her name, but cuts a very imposing, glamorous figure whenever she walks in the room. You think that Cow is maybe a little bit in awe of her. She's one of those people that's apparently very easy to talk to. She is a registered companion.
Interesting.
Okay, so she's dangerous?
Yeah.
Only if provoked.
I mean, does Nova know anything about her?
Yes,
Nova knows a little bit about her. Let's have a look. She's known to have a very expansive client list. There are persistent rumours around Big Cassie that nobody's ever been able to prove. She tends to promise special training to potential companions. and then they disappear.
Oh.
Okay, so she's trouble.
So she's
dangerous.
Pretty much, she's a slaver, right? That has to be the cover.
That's the implication, but
yeah,
yes,
I figure.
So she's got registered companion status, but yep. She's not using it. Mm-hmm. Lovely.
Yeah, she's enjoying the good life on Renau. She's enjoying being wined and dined by Sharklip. They seem to be. It's not a relationship, but she's definitely spending a lot of time with Sharklip.
Okay. A mutual understanding, as they say.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Red?
Yes.
A mutual.
And yes, this point, reaches over and smacks Isaac upside the head.
Hey, that wasn't me. That was
that was not intentional.
So those are your players.
Wait. Oh, here's this side. Haha, it's him. Stealth, unintentional puns are the best.
Yeah.
I think you're the only one that made the pun.
So yeah, in the game itself, you'll be playing Big Cassie, Sharklip, Butch, and Colonel Baines. But expect Lula to be there.
Okay.
As she's always accompanying the Colonel.
Have we determined why Butch wants us out of the game? Oh, sorry.
No, we need to speak to him about that.
Do we let him know that we made them talk and everything? Is that wise?
He knows.
Well, probably, yeah.
There's no way he doesn't know. Because one of his guys reported back. So.
Oh, true, right. We didn't kill all of them. This is why I always say, kill all of them.
We didn't kill anyone.
Yeah, you just knocked them out.
It was all on me. The only one who tried to kill anyone was me.
Listen, I got shit for it last time. If we're here investigating a murder, the last thing we want to do is murder people.
What did you do with the one that you interrogated, by the way?
I think we stopped that piece of information. We might have let him go. I think we let him go.
No.
Did you let him go or hand him over to the sheriff?
Sheriff? I think actually we handed him over to the sheriff.
Fine. I know what happened. The sheriff went up to like open up his office in the morning, and in there, like, Hogtied was just that guy went like, Oh, thank God you're here. These people left me here for like 8 hours. They're monsters. He just got a big note pinned to his forehead saying, I destroyed casino property.
Yes, that's
that sounds like something we'd do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I probably put my signature at the bottom so he knows it's
and
the
smiley face.
And there may be a drawn dick on his face somehow.
Whoa.
Hey, whoa. I'm not that crass. If I was doing it, it would be tattooed on.
Oh,
wow.
It's Firefly, they probably have technology for removing tattoos, but you know.
True.
Oh, one thing I did forget to mention about Butch, sorry. Most of the mercenaries, sort of the high-ranking mercenaries in his group, are the people who were in his unit during the war. He's obviously recruited more since.
Obviously.
So, connections.
Good point, so he didn't have any trousers on when the sheriff found them, because Wu took them.
Underwear or trousers?
I specified trousers. Wu steals trousers.
Okay.
Was there anything else you wanted to know from the sheriff before he wanders off to his normal duties?
He's identified, let me just go down the list, Lulu, Baines, Butch, and Big Cassie is what you called her.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anyone else we need to be aware of?
No, those are your competitors that you would meet at the game.
So, Lulu is a nurse with little info. Colonel is, X Alliance.
X, possibly.
Actually, hang on. Question. If I were to try and pickpocket Lula's pockets, what skills would I roll?
I don't think there's much room for pockets in that dress.
Yeah, but she has pockets? Have you ever worn one of those? There's not much room for pockets.
Also, no, I'm not wearing a floozy dress.
What are you looking for?
Do you know how much info you can get from a wallet?
A lot.
As she's only grabbing breakfast, she's not got a handbag or anything with her.
Damn it.
We might have to actually talk to her. Sounds right up your alley.
General Baines, X-Alliance Encrypted Records. Butch X Browncoat, did you say? Likes to loot things.
And a mercenary.
This is a high-class casino. It's called a tab.
Merc. Big Cassie, companion slave trader. Okay, that's all my notes up to date. Right. Actually, does that mean that did he send goons after us, or did he send like his
goons?
His guys. Oh, he sent his goons. Okay. Right.
I'm assuming his actual employees would be far more competent.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Well, they're ex-Broncos. They're not really that competent, are they?
Yeah, he's basically sent a bunch of low-level thugs that are looking for a promotion.
Thanks a lot.
Well, they surely didn't deserve to be promoted then.
Well, to be fair, all he's seen of you lot is you showed up in some fancy clothes, had a posh dinner,
yes,
and then forced your way into a high-stakes Faro game.
I'm the standard. So they probably saw me and went, yeah, they're not going to be that tough.
we could probably send the kindergartners in there.
Which is interesting, because it means he's not in the card game for money.
How do you mean?
Well, if he wants us out, like, look at what... he's either worried that Wu will cheat, or Blackie will cheat, or he doesn't want extra players in the game.
Uh-huh.
I don't know why he wouldn't want extra players in the game, because if you think you can win at this card game, you would want more money. But that's the point of a card game, get money.
Maybe he doesn't want a wild card?
That, or what if he's planning to do something against Shark Lips and doesn't want witnesses?
That's the other thing I'm thinking about. That might also make him a suspect for Annie's killing.
We've got the Colonel here. We should probably go talk to him, see if we can find out anything.
Have Lula here.
Yeah, we have Lula.
She's going to the Colonel. Yeah, Colonel is in his room.
You are correct. Okay, in that case...
I mean, we could just go to Butch and punch his face in.
Okay. I think that's not advisable until after the game started at some point.
Yeah, I think we want to...
We don't want to piss off people in the game too early.
No, but we could still go to him and talk to him about the fact that he sent goon after us. Goons.
That's something I'm thinking about, yeah.
Okay, what's the plan of action then? What's the first thing we want to do?
I say we either talk to Lula and get any information about Baines that we can, or we go find Big Cassie.
We split the party and do both at the same time.
We should have Nia talk to Lula then, actually, before we do anything else, because they might have things in common.
Excuse me?
Lula?
Woo and Lula.
No, I have a theory. You trust me on this.
Okay.
Whenever I look people up on Cortex and there's little to no information about them, things happen.
I see what that's
Yes,
wait,
I have.
Did you guys look me up?
There wasn't anything.
Oh, right. Well, yes. That was... we should talk about that sometime. Hey, let me go chat up with
her. Wait, you couldn't find... And as she leaves, I turn to Isaac like, you couldn't find anything?
Just like with Asante?
Keep an eye on her.
Almost exactly, Eliza.
By the time you finish this conversation, Lula has got a tray of food and is just heading out of the bunkhouse.
Okay, so I'm going to walk up to her and possibly slightly bump her, but not enough to disturb the food, and say, "Oh, excuse me, quite a full tray you have there. Can I help you with it?"
She sort of... I'm not going to do the accent, but she's got the sort of the Californian Valley girl type accent. And she just giggles and says, no, I'm fine. Thank you.
Oh my God, am I totally fine?
Oh, but you don't look like you're staying. Surely you've got a long way to go.
She says, this is fine. I fetch the Colonel's breakfast every day.
Oh, the Colonel? Are you with Colonel Baines?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, I didn't know he was here this weekend. That's just excellent. Is he going to be out and about at any of the events?
He comes out of his room occasionally, ma'am. Enjoys playing cards.
Oh, cards. Well, that's lovely. Do you know his business this weekend?
We've got a nice game of Faro this evening.
Oh, that sounds lovely. Do have a good day.
So as you reach this point in the conversation, you've kind of left the public areas and you're just in a quiet corridor in the hotel. And just as you are turning to leave, the accent sort of drops, and in a much harsher tone, she just says, "Mind your own business."
Nailed it.
I am. And I walk off while keeping my guard up to the back.
Did you...
All right, do I get attacked? Do I have to roll initiative?
Nope.
Okay.
She just continues walking off to the Colonel's room.
Did she, did you two, like, shake hands or anything?
No.
No, okay.
I brushed into her. Just kind of, you know, to give me a reason to talk to her. It's pretty obvious. It's
interesting.
So when I get back to the group, I let them know that
Lula's what, sorry?
Not as nice as she seems.
Oh, that's a shame.
Yeah, I think there's a little deal going on under this Faro game.
Well, I mean, we're just here to, you know, have a good card game and enjoy ourselves, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think. I very much don't trust this woman, but I don't know what she's capable of.
I'd say she's definitely capable of hitting someone.
Yeah, I got that impression as well. I'm wondering how much she's, like, near, though.
There's more
to find out.
I think there's more to this Faro game than just the money. There's something
there's
else going
lot.
On here.
There's a lot more to this Faro game than the money.
Okay, well, doesn't matter to us, does it? Let's go, guys.
I think it does matter, but we'll find out.
Yeah, because I don't really want to end up dead out of this. I mean, there's enough deaths going on right now.
Yeah, so you need to decide which three of you are going with Wu to the game.
Isaac is definitely going.
Yes.
Okay.
Isaac is the only guy for this.
First of all, was it only two of us or three of us?
You and three. An entourage of three.
Okay.
So one person has to stay behind.
And, well, no, what about Nova?
Yeah.
Is she coming along?
But
I don't know if Nova's going to be much help. I think we might be putting Nova in a bit more danger than is
strictly necessary. Because
volunteers to stay behind, because she can always sneak in if necessary, or try to.
I could stay behind and be on opposite sides of the building and shoot at people.
Yeah, but it's providing there's a window available.
Yeah, a piece of information for you. The game is taking place in Shen's penthouse, which occupies the entire 20th floor of the North Tower.
Then I'll be in the South Tower.
Do you have that good of a scope?
Oh, trust me, honey. You don't even know what I can do with a rifle.
That also brings up a good point. Actually, that's what I want to do. Can I do a notice check on Nia?
I know what you're thinking.
Yeah. Because Nia's good at a couple of things, and I have a funny feeling about this person that I may have...
I mean, you can just ask her to check her pockets.
Yeah. Nia, can we, like, check your pockets?
Sure, Nia empties out her pockets. There's a access room key card, or meal card. A couple miscellaneous knives, some throwing stars, possibly a bottle of,
So we're gonna walk out of the restaurant. Don't take this the wrong way, but could you put your arms up for me?
No, you want to die?
Not really.
Okay, then how about you just ask me directly?
When you brushed up against Lulu, are you sure you know what happened?
If you're asking if I pickpocketed her, the answer is no.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, did she, like,
play something on you?
I'm concerned that she might have tried to pull a fast one on you because she may have seen us together with Blackjack Blackie.
She kept her hands on the tray at all times.
Yeah, she was holding a tray of food, so yeah.
Well, I mean, Nia's very good at doing things like that, and I'm kind of extrapolating off of that.
Besides, you think I'd let somebody touch my knives? I just sharpened those.
Look, no, you're not.
Can we for the peace of mind, can we check? Can you check?
Okay,
yeah, you check.
Fine.
I don't have to do it. I'm hands off.
Naps can check, Isaac can't.
Wait, sorry, what?
She's inviting you to do a pat-down.
Okay. Fine.
I'll help with this.
Or should I make
I'm watching this.
Do I need to make a check?
I'm staring at Saps while he's doing it.
I'm tempted to make you do a check for having to attend a sexual harassment seminar afterwards.
He's
the boss.
What is this, muggles in offices?
It'd be more like making a check against how badly do you piss off Nia and she needs you in the face.
Yeah. Isaac's quite happy not to have to do this.
I'm okay with making this check.
I love how little you trust each other.
I gotta say, Zap's not gonna do anything.
Well, so far, since we walked into this place, Isaac hasn't trusted anyone or anything. Like, he's halfway concerned the sheriff might have done it.
You almost shot those performers.
Look, that was their own fault. As soon as they started firing the guns, then I realized they had blanks in them. But when they hadn't, when they pulled the guns, they looked real, alright?
You know, threat assessment is part of your job.
Yeah.
Proper.
Giving Zaps a big damn hero dice, a plot point rather, I can't give him a big damn hero dice, for volunteering to be the one to frisk Nia. That takes guts.
I mean, I wouldn't do it.
Zaps is a brave man in his own way.
Yes.
No, Zaps is a suicidal man.
I will take the bullet and put my hands on this lovely young lady.
I will take the bullet and put my hands on this lovely young lady who could murder me where I stand.
Twice before I hit the ground.
Zaps, like, three out of the five people in this group could murder you.
Okay.
I'm saying four.
Okay.
You don't know what Wu can do with a kazoo.
Do I need to set the stakes or raise the stakes?
Nia will set the stakes, and then you can raise
them. Do you want me to roll?
Yep.
But what?
What?
Anything that makes Nia vicious.
whatever you need to roll to, whatever you feel you need to roll to have Zaps perform a pat down on you without you killing him.
Social and survive? Sounds good.
Physical. Okay.
Can I make a survive check instead of notice check?
Physical, Laura.
Notice, yes.
Roll Wudang style as a d4 because it's a disadvantage because all you right. might accidentally punch him.
Okay, so I'm rolling physical, my notice, for screwed, and Wudang style as a d4.
So you gain a plot point for that.
Yep.
gaming the system.
Yeah. Well, you have no idea. Wait until I get to roll.
There we go.
Oh!
14.
That is a 14.
Oops, I didn't put the wrong braces
it's
in.
It's 14. K2. That's fine. Yeah, without space.
Okay, so I take a d8 for my mental. I take a d6 for notice, unless there's another skill I'm allowed to use.
I think survive.
If I'm allowed to use survive, that's... I'll gladly do that, because that's higher.
I will let you use it, yep.
Okay, then it becomes a d8. I also take
you're just trying to survive. You're not trying to actually pat her down at this point, because you realize just what stupid thing it was that you're doing.
It's like, it's so the 2 seconds beforehand, like, holy shit, she has knives. I've seen him, she put him on the table.
Let's move this along.
Okay, so I also take a d4 for a little nervous around guns, because let's be honest, those arms are lethal.
I want to see you roll that as a D8. I want to know the context in which you would roll that as a D8.
I have been thinking about this. There are scenarios where that will work.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, 14. So you survived, barely.
Yeah.
Wait, no, I
no,
don't.
No, you didn't have to
it's
keep.
11.
It's an 11.
Oh, yeah, it's 11.
Oh,
Oops.
Even better. Yeah, 11.
Oh, yeah, 11.
Hex so 13 that, would have been enough.
That's a fail. Would you like to describe what happens then?
Sorry.
Ooh.
And as he realizes his mistake and tries to stand up, Mia jerk reaction is to throw a punch at him, and he has a nice big black thing on his cheek. Sorry.
Oh.
What are we done here?
Why?
Did you find anything?
Ow!
Did you find anything?
No.
Okay.
See? All right, are we done now?
Isaac will drop the axe then and stop, because he's been since you interacted with her, he's been acting like, you know, she would if he was listening, how she would expect us to be acting, rather than how we actually are.
Okay.
And he will continue to be distrustful of everyone we meet. So let's go meet someone else, so I can distrust the hell out of them.
Let's go meet Butch.
Yeah, part of me really wants to just knock on Butch's door and be like, "Hey, hi, jackass."
No, no, he's at the casino floor, so run into him while gambling.
And it looks like you were beat up now, so that he doesn't know that we just wiped the floor with his goons.
Oh, in that case, I'd like to find his table and play a game.
Take more money from the rich. Let's
yeah.
go.
We're going to do this to everyone we come across.
In a casino?
When
yes.
he has the chance, yes.
How is it you keep losing to Isaac every time he makes a bet with you, but you can win at this?
Because there are actually rules involved in this.
Right.
Plus,
Zaps the rules lawyer, Engelbert.
Who says he doesn't know damn well that he's losing every time?
Fair enough. Okay, so it's a toss up. We probably can't get in to meet the Colonel. Do we want to meet Butch or Big Cassie?
I really want to meet Butch.
Okay,
because I'm gonna go off on also my own.
I'm constructing a line of thinking also, which says that maybe Annie found out what Big Cassie was up to and was going to tell someone, and that's why she got stabbed. Like, that's the only motive I've been able to come up with so far.
Fair enough.
Okay.
I mean,
we'll make your meeting with Butch the last one before the game, because the whole point of the game is, whilst Wu is going to be playing, you are there in a closed environment with plenty of time to interrogate all these people and figure out who's guilty
or not.
Don't worry
about
in that case, skip
that's
this.
Fine.
Keep going.
Yeah.
I'm sorry,
going
to the 20th I don't want to railroad you too much.
By the way.
That's fine.
No, that's fine.
But the game is basically set up as a way for you to figure out who
is... Eliza, aren't you coming along?
No. It was agreed upon that I would stay behind because I'm the best at dealing with things from range.
We're putting Eliza somewhere she can see in through the window with her scopes. In case everything does go to hell, then she can save our asses.
Got it. Well, in that case, Nia, will you accompany me?
Sure. And she kind of puts her arm through, and they're like, you sure you want to do this? I just punched you.
Yeah, but I had that coming.
Okay.
I think maybe he liked it.
Like, or he debates punching Isaac and decides not to at this moment.
So, Keeb, I'm guessing that I can just be on the 20th floor of the South Tower.
Yes.
Good.
Or a little higher, if you prefer.
No, I want straight across.
Yeah, clear lines.
If this game had... Oh, it does! If I could spend a plot point and have, like, a big glass box that we play Faro in.
Yep.
Oh, go on, then let's do that.
As fun as that would be, I've got a fantastic description of what Shen's penthouse looks like.
Fine. Oh, let's do that.
So, so are we just going to fast forward to the evening, then?
Yes.
Yeah, I think we'll all, like, we'll lay out our strategy of getting Wu in there and then protecting...
Okay, is Nova going to be with Eliza or elsewhere?
I think we want to keep her out of harm's way.
I feel like we want to keep Nova
at our chamber's
way.
I don't think she's
nowhere near anyone with any sort of weapons or anything.
We did put her in quite a lot of danger last time.
Yeah. I think I want to keep her safe. I agree.
So yeah. So you take the elevator up. I presume you're all dressed in your finery again.
Obviously.
I was forced.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm guessing Wu was forced into a shower and she's had the makeup applied. And...
Fatigues in the tank top.
not forced to shower, forced to look nice.
Just near there with a hose.
Just washing up.
Eliza would participate in that because that would be something that would happen.
So yeah, the doors of the lift open directly into Shen's penthouse. And it's like stepping back in time. The room has genuine vintage high back chairs, mirrored bar, lots of mood lighting. The Faro table is in the centre of the parlour with lots of chairs around it for the entourage as well as the players. You can see there's a small balcony off to one side.
Can I be wearing a Sherlock Holmes hat?
Yeah.
Tearstalker?
As you step out of the elevator, you are met by four guards. They say you're allowed to keep hold of personal weapons, knives, etc., but any firearms will be held behind the bar.
Okay, and I hand over my three-shooter.
Do they have scanners of some sort?
Yeah.
Isaac will... Isaac will reach... will pull out the holster, the gun from his holster, and hand it over because it looks real enough. Then he'll pull out his actual pistol from inside the shoulder holster. Then he'll pull out the one from his boot. Then he'll pull out the one from the small of his back.
I dread to think which of those is the plasma pistol he kept hold of.
How do you move with so many guns?
It's easy. Get used to it.
You get absolutely used to it. He's still keeping the sleeve knife, the piano wire in his watch, and the what was it? Oh, yeah, the boot mounted other knife that he has.
I'm seeing Isaac being played by forget his name all of a sudden. Idris Elba as James Bond.
Yes. That is absolutely Isaac's character.
Just Idris Elba, James Bond. Please, universe, make it happen.
Someone, did you hear when someone said that Idris Elba was too street to play James Bond? And someone else replied with, yeah, mate, fucking Savile Row.
Yeah.
Of everything you can call Idris Elba, street is not the word I use. Distinguished, maybe, yes. He might be too classy to play James Bond. That I would believe.
Once upon a time, James Bond was the gentleman spy.
Yeah. Anyway.
Okay, so the way this is going to work.
Do you have yourself muted or not?
The other person.
Oh,
I
you're
see
right.
Playing...
I did.
Sorry, I thought you were talking. And not, we
the
didn't
other
hear
person
anything.
I can see playing him is Chiwetel. I can't pronounce his last name.
Yeah, who was the operative?
Yeah, the operative. Chiwetel Ejiofor.
Okay.
Yes, Eve, that's what I'm going to say.
Game-related question.
I probably mangled it.
Is this a metal detector or a gun detector?
It's a little bit more advanced than a metal detector, but...
They said I could keep personal weapons. I'm keeping them.
Yeah, so you're allowed to keep your knives and everything like that. That's
okay.
Fine.
Nice. The stress doesn't hide as much. It's such just a knife.
Yep.
Like knives, ninja stars.
I'm looking up
gun swords.
Kunais.
The kunai are my other outfit.
Can keep your kosh.
Probably just a Bowie knife, maybe a flip. You know.
Oh, that's, Michael Clark Duncan is also an excellent actor that could play him so.
Let me check this.
This is our small talk as we're walking into the game.
Wu, your kazoo is confiscated.
No.
That's a weapon of mass destruction right there.
My grandfather always used to tell me that the definition of a true gentleman is a man who understands and knows how to play the bagpipes, but doesn't.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Okay. So, the way this is going to work... you go ahead.
Just quick thing. I'm saying that the crew has a tiny earpiece so that they can hear me potentially saying something to them.
I was going to assume you all had comms because that may be extraordinarily relevant at some point.
Yeah.
Also, I think Jack has an ability for this, but we're kind of bypassing it where he can do the whole vantage point thing. We're just kind of setting that up in plot rather than in plot points.
Yes.
I mean, you could use a plot point to make sure nobody finds him.
Or to get a D8...
Asset, yes.
Sure.
So, I'm presuming that Eliza has like a little montage where she's walking up to this place with a suitcase and then like sort of setting up and assembling it in it.
I presume you've spoken to the sheriff to arrange the correct room with the correct vantage point, because I'm not going to make Eliza roll for it, because if she botches again, she'll be looking at the out over just empty wilderness instead of the North Tower.
It's like,
please don't make me do that again.
I would have sworn it was a building here.
This is really boring. When's something interesting going to happen? Explosions, gunfire, screaming. Oh, man. Why do I never get to do any of the fun stuff?
But yes.
What I'm actually seeing is that he's looking through the scope and seeing a lion attack at deer. It's like, nature is so cruel.
Yes.
And yet so beautiful.
Actually, he shoots the lion.
Eliza sets up in the room, opens the window, lies on the table, looking across with her rifle, ready to shoot at a moment's notice.
Okay.
Not ready to shoot staffs, ready to shoot other people.
Yes, I just said I was ready to shoot. I never told anyone who I was aiming at.
That's what I'm here for, Zaps, don't worry about it.
Eliza, through your scope, you occasionally think you catch the glimpse of a dead body lurking in the back of the room.
What?
I am the ghost of the body of an Eva boy. I am haunting you in particular because you lost me, you silly person. Oh.
Exactly.
Sorry, that took me a moment.
I knew where this was going.
Okay, so while Eliza is going slowly mad in her sniper vest.
Also, by the way, can I see the opposing player's cards? From
no.
Where I am? No? Aww.
And I'm pretty sure they're going to take away Wu's communicator when she starts playing.
Right. So the way this is going to work, we're not going to make Wu actually... We're not going to make Valk actually play out the game. There'll be a roll for each round of cards. Each of the other gamblers at the table has a D10 complication of suspicious. Once per round of cards, you can attempt to remove a gambler's suspicious complication.
What? Wait, they have a complication or an asset?
Complication.
Why would we want to remove their complication?
Their complication, they will give you their alibi for her murder.
Ew. Because at that point, they'll trust us enough to... Ah, I see. To talk to us. Yes. Okay, that makes sense.
So they're suspicious of us? No, we're suspicious of them?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Obviously, you can talk to anybody else in the room, but the action is kind of revolving around trying to remove those suspicious complications.
So that they are no longer suspects.
Yeah, and eliminate them as suspects.
Makes sense. Now I get it.
Alright, let's do it to it.
Okay. Let's go.
And as you've discovered from their brief sort of descriptions, most of them are also hiding some kind of secret. So you might be able to find out some of that information as well.
Okay, so they'll have alibis, and we need to get their motives.
Yeah. And we may bust up a weapons trade here too. So, you know, hey.
Yeah, slavery.
Yeah, I mean, it depends on whose side we want to be on.
Smuggling ring, possibly
since when we pick sides other than ourselves.
I will admit, I am gaming the system somewhat here, but does Lulu, is that her name?
Lula.
I'm being very careful not to refer to her as Lulu because I will get punched.
Why?
My nickname is Lulu.
Oh.
Ah. I will call her Lula then. Does Lula have a complication on her as well?
No. Just the gamblers.
Okay.
Oh no, wait, yes. Yes, she does have a complication on her. Sorry, I just checked.
Ooh.
She does.
I mean, she is a possible suspect, obviously.
Yeah, exactly. Like everyone here is. Everyone at the game is. And she'll be there because the Colonel's there.
Yeah.
Well, the thing is, if the Colonel was the one who wanted Annie murdered,
he would use her to,
Do it.
Yeah, but there's... Huh.
You said... What did we know about the Colonel again? Sorry, just quickly.
Didn't he have an eye on Annie?
Retired Alliance, served with distinction.
Yep,
he has a portion of his war record sealed. That's
and
what we know.
Lulu's the nurse. Does he have a health condition? I can't remember.
He's in a wheelchair.
Oh, wheelchair,
so he's
right.
He's physically incapable of having stabbed her in the chest with a kitchen knife.
Unless he's
out of this room.
Unless he can.
Unless he's cheating?
Support. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Isaac, while you're in the elevator, your glasses gave you a ding.
Ah!
The sealed parts of his records indicate that he was involved in cover-ups and scandals all throughout his career.
Interesting.
Anything specific?
There's no specific details mentioned here, but there's... Isaac would have enough details to...
I did a bloody good impersonation of Red Nightmare then with that question.
Yeah.
Was he dishonorably discharged, or did he, like, just early retire?
Early retirement.
Yeah, okay, I figured that'd be the case.
Was he the cause of the cover-ups, or was he the guy who did the covering up?
Any record of being wounded on service?
Let me just check. No record.
That's what I thought.
Sly dog.
All right.
Nice, Nath. Nice.
It gets the plot thickens. So we've got more suspects than we thought we did. Okay.
Well, let's get into this. Suspects in this murder or suspects in something else?
Everything.
I think they're all guilty of something.
Yes.
So I will share this information with the crew and say that I found some more stuff on him and that he is he's probably not well, he may have been injured after the war, but I find that unlikely. He's probably more capable than he lets on, and I'm not sure if his nurse will be aware of that or not, but if she is, then they've still got something going on.
I'm pretty sure they're aware.
Okay,
you could fake being in a wheelchair. Like, he could be faking it to her as well. She might not.
I told you, she's not as dumb as she looks. She knows what's going on.
Yeah, that's why I'm suspicious of her. But I'm just saying, it's theoretically possible. Okay.
I'm as right before the doors open, Isaac just gets a look on his face and says,
"You're Zaps. Me, Isaac. You Zaps."
Zaps gets a look on his face and is like, "We're walking into a room that with people who might all kill us."
And that's different from normal. How?
Don't worry, boss. I'm here with a scope on them.
Must be Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday.
Why do we never get a day off?
Huh? What was that, Cube?
It's a day ending in a Y.
Yeah, exactly. Yes. Day ending in a Y.
It's in a month with Mondays.
This is why I get paid.
This is why I don't.
So I'm just double checking whether you remove the D10 or if you just step it back.
I get paid.
Right.
Zaps doesn't know who pays Isaac. But somebody
stop
pays
bringing
him.
That up. I know what you're doing.
I'm just reminding the crew of your little situation.
I know.
I was just digging it into Isaac about...
I
was saying to Laura earlier, I'm fairly confident that next episode is going to be the one with the revelations.
I've got a plan for the next episode. It's the one you turned down, has some really interesting potential, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, I have an idea of where this is going, and I already have plans for that. Narrative-wise. I really hope I get to do something.
Did we catch on camera this time?
Better. Because it'd be an incredible shame if that doesn't get on camera. But we'll see if it even happens.
I'd rather than miss Nia falling flat on her face. That would be great.
Mm. Anyway.
Did it miss that?
No, it caught that, and then Eliza's powder burns, and then cut out.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
I don't know how epic a bard Wu actually is.
It's kind of thematically appropriate, because the shotgun goes off, and then it just all goes black.
Anyway.
Next time
let's
boom.
Let's get in.
Yep, so you'll be stepping back the complication each round.
Got it.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Who do we want to go after first?
I'll work Cassie.
Oh, can we do multiple?
Of course, we don't have to group up on one person.
Okay, right. So in that case, you three go ahead. I'll just sit here and look pretty.
Well, then who am I supposed to take? Because I'm pretty sure Lula and Baines both hate me right now.
Good point, actually.
And or may out me.
Baines might not, but you can always talk to Butch.
Yeah, sure. I'm also prepared to talk to Butch if you want to take Cassie.
I'll take Cassie.
Got it. I'll tell you, Butch.
You just have to wear. Lula still may out me. Or I'll hurt her either way.
If it comes to that, as far as you were concerned, you were just a game player of Faro and looking to get some more information about your opponents. That's a perfectly understandable, reasonable thing to be doing. And it, you know, she can't really out you on that because you can explain it away.
Okay.
I'm going to stop doing air quotes. I keep doing air quotes.
Okay, so the way this will work is everybody around the table rolls against the dealer. The first dealer is going to be Sharklip's Shen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then the dealer picks who is going to be the next dealer.
So is Wu the only one rolling for cards, or the rest of us?
Wu is the
talking?
Only one you got into the game. The rest of your entourage.
Got it.
Okay. Cool.
People also have entourages?
Yes.
Okay. Are they all suspects?
No.
No.
Thank God.
Just the named ones.
Okay.
In real life, yes. In this episode of a TV show, no.
Yeah.
We're not going to pull a Scooby-Doo and have it be the first character we met, otherwise it's the sheriff.
What if it is, though?
Don't do this to me.
And I would have gone the way we did if you weren't doing bad thing, kids.
We'll make some bad thing again.
Right, now, Wu, this is going to be important for you. Okay. When you do these rolls, if you fail to raise the stakes, you're out of the game.
Oh dear.
If you raise the stakes, you stay in the game, that's fine. And an extraordinary success, you get a Got Them Talking asset that you can use on your next roll.
Cool.
Okay. Oh god, such pressure.
We lend Wu dice.
This is Wu's big moment. She's sort of been, you know, like a support character for Earth until now, but this is her big break.
Yeah, this is a Wu episode.
Yeah.
Finally.
Wu episode.
I would like to see Wu succeed.
Yes.
Well, maybe disappointed.
He'll be fine.
Don't joke, Falk. He'll be alright. But if you screw this up,
Wu's really good at this. Don't forget.
And yeah, so Wu will be playing the game. Between rounds, you may attempt to deduce the suspect. And any of you may do that. And you will have a roll for that. A failure to raise the stakes just steps it back. If you raise the stakes, it just removes that suspicious complication altogether. And an extraordinary success gains you an asset against that person.
Got it.
So we will start with the first round. And that is going to be Sharklips Shen. Rolling.
One.
He will be rolling mental and focus and smoke-filled room. I suppose we're going for the atmosphere with the cigars and everything here.
So.
Okay.
Oh.
As it gets all noir again.
And he gets to roll a d10.
Huh?
Because Wu is a known cheat.
Yeah.
Oh.
I'd almost forgotten about that.
Oh.
Oops. Are we screwed now?
Yeah. Pretty much. So that's going to be his
botch,
mental.
Botch.
God, this audio correction is so weird.
Botch.
Never makes any sense why it's doing it.
His focus.
Oh,
it's not a botch,
okay.
But that's not the worst. That's a 9.
That's a 9. Okay.
Two.
Oh,
you
you
can
may
do it.
You can roll social and influence, or social and trick, or if you prefer, mental and notice, or mental and focus. I've got
do
a sneaking suspicion you are going for social and trick. Knowing
yeah.
Do all of these people have the D10 on Wu?
Yes. Because she
oh
is
dear.
A known cheat.
Oh dear. Oh
so is dear. It social and trick?
Yeah.
And if you've yes. got a specialization in trick that applies, please use that.
I do. It's misdirection.
Yes.
Okay,
perfect.
There we go.
You also have the D10 from their suspicious.
Yes,
don't
which you
we
may
get
roll.
To roll that as well. Yeah. Okay. See?
Oh, that makes
they're
sense.
They're suspicious as well.
And, of course, do you have one of the distinctions that's useful?
Misdirection.
No, that was a focus no. on it on
oh,
their
yeah,
skill.
That.
A D8 distinction we should have or something.
Wait, like Smooth Talker. No,
yeah.
No, Smooth Talker works here, but...
The D6 is misdirection. Like a politician...
Yes! That would apply.
You can roll that as a D8. Or you've got Smooth Talker, which you could roll as a D8, which I'd probably say is better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's a D10 for the social, D12 trick, mm-hmm. D6
for the
specialty.
Yeah.
D8 for proposition, and then is it D10 for suspicious?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So that's curly brackets, KEH2, isn't it?
Yep.
Yep. No space. Brave face, no space.
Nice.
Yeah! Nice.
Nice. Not a single nice. Jinx.
Yeah, and that is an extraordinary success. So not only do you get a D10 big damn hero dice.
So Shen, how murderific are you feeling today on a scale of 1 to 10?
Oh, you should have also rolled an extra D6 against Shen, because he's still embarrassed from earlier. I forgot about that.
Ah!
Oh.
I'm terribly sorry. But you've beaten him pretty epically, so...
You can't roll better than a 6 on a D6.
Mm-hmm.
And that was beaten by the 7.
Yeah. So you get your big damn hero dice.
Mm-hmm.
and yeah, you get a... got them talking D6, which you may use on the next roll. So that's kind of a temporary asset, which will give you an extra D6.
Nice. Note that down. Note that down. Is that for Shen or just a general asset?
For Wu, basically.
So it's an asset for Wu that can be used on anyone. Sweet. So that steps down his complication to a D8? Or does it step it down? I don't know. What does
no,
it do?
That doesn't step it down. That's just Wu staying in the game.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Stepping down is between rounds.
Yeah.
Oh,
so that's
okay, right.
That's a round of Faro done. Wu is still in.
So do I add the asset?
Yes. Okay. But it only applies for the next round of the game.
It's a single asset, but it's still a D6.
Okay, so you guys have got 5 minutes between rounds now.
Okay, I'll talk a Butch. Me and go have a chat with Cassie. Wu, go see how Sharklips is feeling, because I want him eliminated as soon as possible.
Okay, who wants to go first?
Saps can go.
Yeah, I'll go first.
And you are talking to...
Butch.
Okay. What would you like to know about Butch?
Walk over, go sit next to him on a bar seat, order a beer. It's like, you know, sending enforcers after somebody makes people look awfully suspicious. Especially when a murder is involved.
He just grunts.
Look, man, I want to lay off you as much as you do. You're a brown coat, I respect that. Had enough dealings with you people in the war. Always paid up on front. Just tell me what you did the other night of murder. We can just all move along, have this over with.
Okay.
We'll roll for this.
What would you like to roll
like?
Against him? You have social and influence, social and trick, or mental and notice.
I will go with social and influence, because that's... I feel what I was doing.
While we're sorting out the roles for that, I can't remember what Butch looks like.
We've got a physical appearance for him.
Nope, we did not.
Nope, it did like not give a physical appearance for Butch.
Oh, it didn't? Okay.
He looks like a potato that's been in vodka for too long.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
That sounds a pretty good description of him. I was going to say, he looks somewhat like... Adam Baldwin, as he looks now, rather than 10 years ago in Serenity.
All right,
is how I was envisaging him.
Makes sense.
What I do get the D10, right? Because he's still suspicious.
He is, yes.
Okay, and I get a D10 for social, a D10 for influence, a D8 for trade with both sides, because I brought that up, and a D10 for. Right, for the is complication. There we go.
Oh, I need to set the stakes.
Oh, well. Balls.
Well, you know. Do that now.
I was working on it. I've got to read off the character sheets, and they didn't print very clearly,
yeah.
So it's taking
and
me.
Then,
no, that's fine. Red got overexcited.
Oops. If you want me to re-roll, just let me know.
That's fine.
I like to spend the plot point.
Yeah? Yep. Yeah, you might.
To keep that 6. So that ups it to a 20, and I beat him.
Yep, so you get a D10 Big Damn Hero Dice.
Yeah, I delete that. I beat by 4, so I don't get any dice.
Oh, by 4, sorry, yep. Yeah. So that's just a standard success.
Yeah, just standard success. So I do eliminate him as a suspect. Or at least I hope he tells me his alibi.
So that gets rid of his complication. Ooh, that's interesting. Okay. Butch just growls really aggressively and unsheaths a really large Bowie knife.
Whoa.
Okay. Saps is unimpressed. It's not a gun.
Oh. He's just like, through gritted teeth, is just like, back off and leave the game.
That's all you gotta say for yourself? Okay. Have a nice drink. Zaps walks away with his beer. I walk out. I don't know if the rest is standing together or not. I'm assuming we reconvene this slightly later moment, and I opened that sentence with, yeah, he did it. Next person.
Alright, I guess I'm going to mosey up to Big Cassie, and...
I'm just checking in case there's a trigger at the end of this one.
Okay.
Sorry, because the various characters have got different things that trigger when you remove their complications.
Okay.
Interesting. Did you try to kill me?
I don't think so.
I'm about to use my right here, sir, privilege, okay?
Yeah. Sorry, I'm just making sure I don't botch anything. Other than my dice rolls, because that's always entertaining. Okay. That's for verifying alibis. Okay, no, there's nothing extra triggers from Butch. He's shown you what he needed to show you there, which was his large knife.
Yeah, Isaac's kind of uncomfortable about that.
Does anybody remember the murder weapon?
It was a knife.
It was a large knife.
Possibly a kitchen knife or a large knife, yes.
That's a good point.
A large knife.
What did the knife look like?
We don't know. We never found it.
No, the one he's holding. The knife was in Annie. That's why she lived so long.
No. We never found the murder weapon.
You never had the murder weapon.
Important question, what type of knife is it?
It's a Bowie knife.
Of course it is. It's a massive knife.
It makes amazing music?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You could probably play them like a saw blade.
It's a large single-edged blade which kinks up at the tip.
And has a handle, most importantly.
Yeah, it has a double handle for defending your fingers.
Yeah, a guard.
I can't remember what you call that.
Guard.
T bit.
A guard.
Called a guard.
Yep.
Yeah. Sorry, I didn't want to again push you in railroad. It's just like I should probably remind you what the murder weapon was, because
I was already thinking that, but I hadn't. Assuming that I'd seen it.
It's a really big he did it. Do we even want to question everybody else now? Because I'm like, I'm trying to think of how to get Cassie not to just tell me to fuck off.
I mean, just do it. There might be more people who did it.
True.
Yeah, like, this could be murder on the Orient Express. Spoiler alert, 50 years ago.
Everyone.
They all did it!
They all did something, yes.
Well, that's my weekend's reading ruined.
If anybody feels like in chat, feels like adding an exclamation mark, Tesla.
Hey, Tesla.
He's hello, annoyed Jeff, because I've spread all my notes out over his bed. Okay, Cassie is going to roll.
Tesla's like, you do realize that now it's been in my bed. I own it.
Yeah. Do not sit on the keyboard, Tesla. I'm just going to move you out of the way.
Damn, I please you, filthy human.
Mental focus and suspicious. So she's going to roll. Oh, her mental's not very good. That's good for you.
Oh, good.
That's an 11 for Cassie to resist your attempt to interrogate and talk to her. Mm-hmm. So, how do you approach Cassie?
Alright, I've come up with this, but I don't think it's very good. So, Mia sidles up and starts with some small talk about how well or poorly or strategy from the last hand. Then says, quite privately, so only Cassie can hear, you know, we're friends of that. Annie was a companion, right? Side note.
She registered? No.
Yeah. Okay.
Annie was just entertainment.
Yeah.
I know. Okay. So, I have some, I've heard from some of my, friends who are in the guild that, there's some suspicion about you. I want you to do me a favor and help remove that suspicion because I don't want to investigate you and you don't want me doing it. What you say?
Okay.
Can I roll my favors?
Yes.
Specialty
yes.
for that? Yes. There we go. So, I am going to roll, would that be a mental?
Social and influence, social and trick, or mental and notice?
Social and influence, okay. So, social plus influence plus my specialty, which is a d6, correct? Specialty in favors. And I don't think I can work my first mate into this at all, can I?
No.
No.
Okay. All right.
Don't forget you can roll the d10 for suspicious.
Oh, yes, you're right. Thank you. Whoa.
Nice.
Well, you get a d10, big damn hero dice.
There is a jinx, though.
Yeah, there is a jinx.
There is a jinx.
I'm not going to capitalize on it.
No.
But yes, an extraordinary success. So, let us see, Cassie. There we go. So Cassie's like, sure thing, sugar. See, the thing is, I've heard your friends here might be interested in doing the odd little smuggling operation.
We do smuggle. Depends on what the cargo is.
We're the most well-known criminals in the verse. What's going on?
I mean, there is a warrant out for us from this system specifically.
Anyway,
Cassie's like, don't look so shocked, dear. I've done my research.
So you just googled Woo.
Yeah.
So are you looking for to make a contract this weekend?
She's yes. I've been looking for somebody to transport my goods for me.
So are these goods require living accommodations?
If you want, previous crews have varied between living accommodations or keeping them with the cattle.
I get your point. Thank you very much. Good luck in the next round.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. You don't have an alibi from her yet. You're not leaving until you have an alibi.
Okay. And she does say, you know, if you're interested, and she names a price that's easily double what Annie owed Wu.
Okay.
Whoa. How does she know about that?
No, it's he's using it as a measurement of money.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but it's also it's like it's coming over my calm because Isaac overheard saying, last time we tried block cargo, it ended up badly. So taking that back in the after the live cargo, I kind of looked at Vicassi and go, I will talk it over with my captain. However, just out of my curiosity, where were you, what was it, 2 nights ago?
Something like that.
Yeah. 2 nights ago now.
Were you enjoying a nice game of cards then too?
No, and she gestures to two of the flunkies behind her. A lovely couple here, Anthony and Lynn. We went out for dinner in the Columbia restaurant. We did notice that you folks were sat around looking a bit miserable at your table.
Yes, we had some very unfortunate news that night. And, I'll kindly make some excuses and make my way back to Zaps.
And as you're making your excuses, she says, you know, if your captain needs a little convincing, we could maybe sort out a free session.
Why does everyone we meet want to fuck Zaps?
Mia decides that she's going to... She nods, as in, yes, I will mention that to him.
Can I listening into this conversation or not?
Well, you could be overhearing on your earpiece. I assume this is taking place simultaneously while you're.
Yeah, but I'm probably not listening in that case.
By Butch.
I can't be distracted.
So, yes, you may.
Isaac is listening.
You may roll to verify her alibi.
Wouldn't we be doing that later? Because we don't really.
Well, I think actually.
Well, you have two crew members on the outside.
This would be a nice job for Nova, actually.
This is why I asked what Nova was going to be doing.
Go to the ask her to go to the Columbia and check the alibi.
Yeah, make sure she was on the guest list.
Wait, no, hang on. That's where
I pick up the
in room
phone over where I am and call Nova and say, "Hey, Nova."
Didn't she just?
You know, the sheriff has a nice security office where all the video feeds are kept.
I'm sure she just... am I imagining this, or did she just mention that we were there too? Is that where we were?
Yes. Yeah, but we weren't paying attention to her at that point.
We
so I can't. We probably don't remember if she was there.
So
or not.
She, Nova verifies the tapes.
Drunk eating lobster, yeah.
Cool. Yeah. I was drunk. I was in no way drunk.
We were drinking, all of us.
I wasn't. I had a... what was it?
I was drinking for
ginger
you.
Beer or something.
So I'm going to need somebody to roll for Nova. She will be rolling.
Who's going to roll?
Whoever fancies it.
Then I roll. Okay. I will roll.
Okay.
Your name is Zaps.
Yeah.
You will roll.
Nova is going to need to roll mental and notice, which I'm afraid is a pair of d6s.
Okay, mental and notice. Do you need to set the stakes for this or not?
I do, yes.
Wait a minute. Hang on. I rewatched the footage from my glasses.
Yeah?
That should verify whether she was there or not, because I will have swept the place when we walked in.
Yeah.
So
you can then do your mental and notice then.
Nice.
Good job. I'm assuming they're better than that.
Of course there's a recording on the glasses.
I mean, you've only got to beat an 8, so.
Oh, I might do an Eliza.
Hey. Let's not call it that preemptively.
Sorry, what was that? I'm just worried I might do an Eliza, so I'm rolling.
I've done it once. I've also had the most incredible success.
And to be fair, it was a great story moment.
Didn't have to worry too much.
Yeah, I mean, you did get a botch in there, a jinx in there, rather, but...
Yes, I did. I will have a complication if you want to give me a complication.
No, that's fine. You verify the alibi. She was indeed there.
That's why you get paid the big bucks.
D10.
That's a D10. I will take that.
There you go.
Thank you.
Yeah.
What is it with you and getting all those big damn hero dice?
I have rolled, on the two occasions when I last rolled D12s, they did both come up 12.
Yeah. Also, yeah, and he tends to actually be
where I had all the dice ever.
Unfortunately, the way this is set up is sitting in a sniper nest doesn't tend to give you all the interactions you need to earn the points.
No, that's cool.
I can verify her alibi, or was she not there?
You can verify her alibi.
Okay, right.
Okay, she cross has that alibi. One off the list.
So you've eliminated the suspicious D10s from two people. Butch did not supply you with an alibi. That's the other piece of information that you should be aware
Big
of.
Big Cassie, companion slave trader, didn't do it.
She might still have hired someone, but...
Wants to shag Zaps.
But let's be
yeah,
honest
pretty
here.
Much.
There we go.
Okay. Who was left doing talking? It was you, wasn't it, Isaac?
Mm-hmm.
And who are you going
to
talk?
I never said that.
Oh yeah, he's going to talk.
Who were you going to go and interrogate? Oh no, you were sitting there looking pretty.
Yeah,
I was. Yes. Looking, I was standing near Zaps in case he got stabbed with a giant knife.
Okay, Wu. Who was Wu going to talk to?
I think it was Lippy. Shen.
Oh, yeah. Shen. Yeah, Shen. Sorry.
I mean, you can choose whoever you want.
One thing is, am I able to get my complication down? Since I managed to win a hand, or am I not?
No.
Because you're not sure if you cheated or not.
That's a good point, actually. That's a good point.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I go over to Lippy.
So you're going to try and find out where he was the night of the murder?
Yeah.
Because I just realised something. Even if it was... who we think it was, he may have been doing it on orders from someone else who does have it. That's complicated and annoying.
He's a merc, remember?
Yeah. Oh, I don't like this. We need some way of figuring out whether he did it or not, and also, like, we need Zaps to do his thing where he annoys someone so much that they tell him the truth.
No, what I think we need now, we first... I mean, apparently
first
means we
book.
Haven't been able to get, though means are starting to get there. Then we have opportunity, and we still need to get motive.
Mm-hmm. I mean...
Yes, motive
basically,
is
the next line of once you've discovered who it is, the crew has to push them to get them to admit their crime. So your plan is exactly what they're expecting you to do, in that it is basically get Zaps to annoy them until they admit it.
I was taking that from the last adventure where that's exactly what we did.
Twice.
Yeah.
True.
So, who were you going to talk to, Wu?
Shen.
Shen. Good old Shark Lips himself. Right.
Lippy.
Lippy, as Wu calls him.
Don't forget you can roll his embarrassed D6 again.
Okay.
You get a lot of dice because you get the D6, you get the D10, you get the D6 for got them talking.
No, that's only for the game.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
Nice.
You can't use it in this between rounds bit.
Oh, that's actually probably better to stay in the game.
Yeah.
So that's mental and focus for Shen. So that's a D6. Another D6. Because that's going to be his... he's stone-faced is his focus skill there. Oh, and he gets a D10 because you're a known cheat.
Yep.
Not quite sure how that applies in here, but he'll
he
roll any dice
him.
He can. Yeah.
Probably as simple as that.
It's okay. 16, but he's got two jinxes, so you may choose to actually step up his embarrassed to a d8 if you want to spend a plot point.
Whoa. No. Wait, does this work in reverse?
Because
I know that...
a d10?
Or you could use your plot point as his
rather
jinx.
It does work in reverse.
You can use your plot point to step back your known cheat.
I think I'll do just that.
But does she have to spend one plot point for both ones?
Yes.
That's why I'm asking in reverse.
Well, let's look that up while we do this. We'll make a note of the numbers later.
Yep. Got it.
Okay. So if you want to do your normal roll, and then we'll sort out your known cheat later.
So what am I rolling? What's
Social and influence, social and trick, or mental and notice?
I'll probably have social influence.
And again, you can use your smooth talker, and I say you get to roll a d6 against him.
Hmm.
And don't forget his d10 for suspicious, because you haven't erased that yet.
Oh, right, yeah. I've got a lot of die here.
Yeah.
Yes, you can actually step back a complication. You can spend several jinxes with one plot point. So you could step back to a d6 with only one plot point.
Yeah.
I'll also use a d6 for my influence specialty, which is wheedling.
Oh, yes.
I'm guessing wheedling something out of him.
Yep.
Right.
This adventure was written for Wu.
Pretty much. Yeah. It's why I picked it. When I saw it was a murder mystery in a casino, I was just like, it's got to be perfect.
Yep.
It's great.
Oh.
Okay. Oh, dear.
You can spend a plot point to keep an extra dice there. So keep your six, that will work.
Yeah, you can keep the six.
What happens if she doesn't?
You step back his complication, you just don't remove it. So that's fine. If you're happy to step it back, his then becomes a d8.
I think we won't spend a plot point here. Because if we're going to spend a plot point to move down my known cheats, then I don't want to get rid of all my plot points. Oh, do I though?
It's fine. I say it steps it back to a D8. You can keep interrogating in between rounds.
I think if you want to spend a plot point, it's probably best to get the known cheat down to D6, because that'll give everybody more chance.
But I mean, I've got three, and this is near the end, so
you also have your episode.
Spend them if you got them.
Yeah, I'm gonna spend a plot point to keep a dice and also another one to step down my known cheat.
Yep.
Okay, so known cheat becomes a d6.
Yep.
You keep a dice, so you remove Shen's suspicious complication.
Mm-hmm. I think I can remove plot points, if I'm not mistaken.
If not, I can.
There we go.
Yeah, Wu isn't allowed to spend that one without a chemist string around, so...
Is that still a thing?
I think she's not going to be able to make it for a while, so...
Yeah.
At some point...
That was from last episode as well.
Yeah.
That was last episode, you're correct.
Ah, no. Mm-hmm.
That's what you get from metagaming.
There we go. That's now a free plot point again.
Okay.
So
you start talking to Lippy. And he sort of, without his goons around, he's maybe filled with a little bit less bravado. I mean, obviously they're guarding the entrance to the room, but they're not immediately with him. He's maybe we got off on the wrong foot, and he invites you out onto the balcony.
Ooh! Wait. How? What floor are we on?
20th.
Oh God!
Yeah.
Can I see this balcony?
Yeah, so the balcony is what you're looking at, Eliza.
Cool. That means that as soon as they step out, I have the scope trained on Lippy, as we've started calling him.
So I'm like, oh, this is a beautiful view of sand. Well, you know, I guess that you've got to have some nice vistas. I've heard people, some people really hate sand. I'm indifferent to it. You know what?
Swear to God.
If I could remember it, I would use the Anakin Skywalker sand quote here.
I was going to say, if anyone uses that, I will cut them.
The Wait, you mean, you mean the fact that sand is coarse, it's rough, and it gets everywhere?
Thank you, Ed.
So, yeah, Shark Clips.
Reading a lore, by the way.
Shark Clips.
Far side of the screen.
So yeah, when you get out to the balcony, there's nobody else out on the balcony at the moment. And he says, "I know that you're working with the sheriff."
No, oh, what makes you think that?
He says, "You've had breakfast with him every morning for the last 2 days."
Touché, sir. Touché. I will give you that you have good powers of observation.
He says, I know why. He says, you're investigating what happened to Annie.
Well, yeah, I mean, she's my friend. You know, that's the only reason we're here. So it's, she invites us to come to this casino. What I find a dead body just after I meet her. It's not exactly the way I wanted to meet my longtime friends.
Do you also want to tell her about the gem we stole and where we hid it, because if we're sharing information anyway.
And he says, you know, I know that somebody in that room killed her.
Well, duh.
Who is it?
He says, I don't know who, I just know it's one of them.
Well, why should we... Why is it not you? What's your alibi, mister?
I was talking to my superiors on Persephone. I can show you the communications logs.
I would like to see those communication logs, thank you very much.
Yep. He also says, I'd appreciate it if you do discover the identity of the killer. You don't get Cow involved. You let me handle it.
Why?
He says, I don't want a reputation for allowing killers in my game and to mess with casino staff. It's ruining my relationship. I need to get rid of the killer and be allowed to continue as was.
Woo, he's a triad. Don't fuck with him.
I've dealt with triads all my life.
Woo has no sense of self-preservation. You know this.
Yeah,
I do. That doesn't mean I'm not going to try and prevent it.
Mia carefully inserts herself and says, "Woo, dear, we need to get you a drink before the next game." Tug.
Blackie.
She's got a good point. Jackie. You know, I need to keep my winning streak up.
Shen's just like, just think about it.
And over the comms, you hear Eliza say, "By the way, make sure to take note of the names." I want that knowledge.
Wait, what?
His superiors. She wants the names of the triad superiors that Shen reports to for reasons that we don't know. Hey, Uno, how are you doing?
Hey,
Uno.
It's an Uno. How are you
doing?
Hope
you had a good sleep.
All the best. Right. So that. I mean, I wasn't planning to talk to anyone, but if you want me to talk to someone, I can go and, you know...
Yeah, you see Shen having a quick chat to one of his goons, and
I
they gesture you over to the
colonel.
They gesture you over to the communications console?
Oh, sure.
So, you need to roll, be on mental notice again.
Okie dokie. Can I use my... No, you know what? I'll just do the three. Mental, notice, and my glasses.
Yeah.
But
I haven't set the stakes yet.
Great. Sorry. I thought you... Oh, no, that's Woo's roll. My bad.
Yeah.
Am I doing anything else other than that? I forgot to add anything else to that, but hey, it's on it. Oh.
Well, you can beat it.
Yeah, plot point.
Well, that will give you an instant verification. Otherwise, if you keep yours or fail, you will verify it after two more rounds of cards.
Oh.
So that means... might be enough.
Yeah, okay. No, that's fine. I'm fine to spend the plot point now. That's not a problem.
I was going to get a clarification. If I get knocked out of the cards, does that mean we can't interrogate them anymore?
There was something here about that. One moment.
Okay, quick. We need to make cow puns to make Uno feel better. Or laugh, at least.
Are you sure that...
No. Those two things may be mutually exclusive.
He'll just start getting flashbacks to the spaceship.
Oh, God, yes!
Oh, God.
No!
I was really sad that it wasn't... like, it's not been saved anywhere, because I wanted to go back and rewatch that.
Yeah.
I mean, Lamb probably has a recording of it, but just as me and recordings, he needs to put them online. I really need to put the Friday Night Survivors episodes online. At the very least. Especially Quiplash.
Yes.
Yeah.
That was
good.
I'm still proud of one of those answers. Despite it probably meaning I go to hell.
I think we all do.
Yeah. I specifically refrained from one that would have sent me to hell, but you know.
I don't know.
So we spent the plot point, Gabe.
I can't find the bit that says what happens if you get knocked out now.
Then we better not get knocked out.
Well, we're just not going to get knocked out. It's that simple. Right.
It's fine. We'll do it on the fly. Mm-hmm. The question was something like the worst people to fly with, and I was going to put down ISIS Airlines.
Yeah.
Oh no, I had at some point there's like a conversation starter for meeting somebody on the subway. And my answer was, hey, could you keep an eye on this ticking backpack for me?
Yeah.
Do you want to see a boner?
Yeah. Do you want to see a boner?
It doesn't have to be my boner.
Okay, well, we'll have to wait until next time for you guys to reveal who the actual killer is, because it is almost 10 p.m. and Laura needs to get away on time, so...
Oh, man.
She needs to go adopt an adorable kitty.
When is our next session, then?
2 weeks. We'll be sticking to Sundays.
Okay. Sundays 2 weeks from now.
Got it.
Sunday 2 weeks from now. Okay, works that makes it the 1st of May.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh, May Day.
Yeah.
Have I
God
already
damn
talked
it, that's about... that's a Sunday? Fuck.
No, that's fine.
Why?
It's the workforce day in Denmark, so basically it's a day off for everybody.
Well, don't they normally shift that to a Monday, if that's...
Nope.
Oh.
Wait, why?
Denmark is not, is not
is
like
bank
that.
Holiday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have a bank holiday May the 2nd.
We do not, I think.
And yeah, hopefully that one will be the conclusion to this story. Because you've got all the information you need.
No, we don't.
Yep.
We're missing one last thing.
Motive. But yes.
Yeah, motive.
You won't discover that until you get that person to confess.
That's just going to be Saps
talking to him. And then, by the way, calling it now, we want to flip him over the balcony.
Doesn't that leave a lot of like mess?
Self defense, always.
You can't flip someone off a balcony in self defense.
Yes, you can.
I mean, you can.
He was attacking me. I flipped him, and then all of a sudden, he was over the balcony. Oops.
Yeah.
I'd like to see you explain how you got to that balcony.
Myself, and then I gave him the last ride.
Oh, ha ha. Okay, whatever.
It's a wrestling move.
Yes, I know.
So, yeah, enjoy looking at kitties, Laura.
Thank you.
Yeah, have fun.
Bye-bye. Off to adopt adorable kitties.
Yep. See you.
We will
see you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Well, thanks for watching, guys.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you very much for watching.
I'm, as always, you know, dying laughing during these episodes. They're too
You enjoy these way too much.
Yeah, because enjoying things too much is a thing that exists, Red.
What people often forget is that when I say you're enjoying this too much, I am completely okay with that, is implied.
Fair enough.
Like, I've seen people making jokes about things, and like, these people are having way too much fun, and I approve of this.
And, yeah, get well soon, you know?
Yeah. Get well soon, mate. You need to be fit as a fiddle for UnoCon.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh. Yes.
And yeah, so yeah, we'll pick this up again in 2 weeks. Hopefully the crew will figure out the killer from the evidence they've been given.
Don't expect too much of us.
Do we want to make it Well, we know it, we're pretty sure it's him, but we don't know if it was him off of his own initiative or if someone else wanted him to do it. And we still have to talk to the colonel and
we need a motive. That's the only thing we're missing.
Figure out what they are about.
True, we still need to talk to Colonel Mustard, but yes.
Oh, and I need to go tell Cassie to go to hell on her deal.
Yeah. Well, I'm assuming they'll be running and screaming on her part when things kick off. But, like, you know, that might put her off doing business like that.
By the way, we might want to do business and then screw her over.
I will say,
I mean,
we
save the slaves and stop her from doing slave trading, boss! Boss, we're good guy criminals.
Are you trying to get have your cake and eat it again? Get
yes,
paid
I want to make as many enemies as possible.
Well,
I mean, we
I'm not entirely. I'd like to have at least one ally out of this.
We do.
Even if
she's called Liliana.
And Nova.
When you're the criminals with heart of gold, that means that you get the good allies, not the bad allies.
Yes.
We do not want a bent companion
as an ally out of this.
I would say that we are
helping Cal, actually.
Here, which is...
Cal works for the Alliance. He, as soon as he figures out who we are, we've got to get off world.
True.
Yeah. Once he dies down, he might like us.
At the moment, you're not really getting paid for this. Your only payment is whatever you earn in winnings, plus getting your ship unimpounded.
Which I was about to say, which is the most important point. We need to drape all their bank accounts.
We are in a high-stakes card game, and Wu is currently winning.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes. That was actually a question I had. How much were we to win if we were to win at all? Is it just four times whatever Wu was owed?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because that would be the taking.
That sounds good.
That would be the take from the game, because
that
there's the one share that we can't have, basically.
Oh no, we can have that. We're just going to make sure that he donates it to an orphanage or something.
Yeah, that sounds good.
I'm completely okay with the money going there. I just don't want the sheriff to have it.
Oh, your question is, do we think that it's going to take the whole of next session for us to do this?
There is more stuff that happens once
knowing us
identified the killer. So,
right,
yes.
Cool.
And again, knowing us, yes, it's going to take a session to do that.
You're only in Act 3, is an Act 4 to this. So.
Oh, sweet.
Ooh.
Okay, nice. Well, in that case, we've got our sort of plan for the thing, which is figure out everyone, like, finish doing the motives, then have some way of revealing the killer, and we have to decide whether we want to just give him over to Shen or call in the authorities or just, you know...
deal with them ourselves.
Have Eliza shoot him off the balcony.
Bearing in mind
if
that
I
the authorities
shoot him,
do have your ship
into
impounded.
The thing.
I mean, that's,
yeah,
that's
something a good point.
That can be solved.
He drew a knife on my boss, I had to shoot him. That's what happens.
Look, what I'm just hoping is that we can have everybody in the room and Zaps at some point can be like, I've got you all today because one of you is a murderer.
And it
and
was
like,
not you, Colonel Mustard.
And they realize, like, yeah, we all are. What's the point?
Well,
a specific murderer.
A specific murderer. This is the murder of Annie.
Oh.
And it was you, Shark Lips. You
We didn't actually resolve Isaac's dice roll, which because he spent his plot point and kept an extra dice.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Which one did you keep? You kept your D8.
No,
he just grabbed the one that was left to D8.
I rolled the
D12.
Kept the
2, that's right, yes, sorry.
I kept the 2, which was on a D8. I probably could have found more stuff to roll on that, but hey.
Or you could have just rolled a big damn hero die.
Because anything would tie it. The lowest roll would tie it, and then that doesn't count.
No,
so.
A 1 doesn't count, so...
Yeah, that's it, but...
I think just using a plot point is cheaper.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then I have the same number of plot points and big damn hero dice, so that's cool.
So, you were able to verify Shen's alibi. There are recordings of his conversation. The timestamps haven't been altered as far as you can tell. The details of the person he was speaking with are encrypted, side of the transmission was garbled as well. So you've got no information.
Could he get anything out of the side of Shen that he could hear?
About who was on the other end?
Yeah.
I mean, to be honest, Isaac's not interested.
Yeah, probably.
No, but Eliza wants the info, and she will make sure that Isaac gets it.
Bound to be triad.
Yeah, I mean, they're largely speaking in code anyway. It's
They're not stupid
enough to discuss matters like that on an open wave.
I'll save you a copy of it, but there's nothing that you're going to get out of it.
Okay, good.
Okay, let's end it on that.
All right,
you've got alibis for 2 people, and one person didn't offer an alibi; they just offered you a very large knife.
Yeah, and I should have just accepted it as like, oh, that's a very nice knife. Thank you very much.
So, mechanically,
stabbed.
Yeah, in the hand.
Mechanically, we know who it is. We have to figure out, we have to all meet up in character and compare notes and figure it out.
Yeah.
Or Eliza's listening in on everything while looking.
We still have to.
Can you follow 3 conversations at the same time?
Technically, yes. In real life.
I can.
I mean, TeamSpeak, it's a thing that happens.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they're not having 3 separate conversations. It's not like 6 people having 3
conversations. You don't hang out on TeamSpeak enough.
No, that's true. So, before we leave, I actually wanted to show one of the reasons I'm so into detectives and stuff.
Alright, Uno. We will see you around. Good luck.
I don't know if any of you know about this board game.
Ooh.
I have not seen that.
It's really cool. So it's basically you have 10 Sherlock Holmes cases.
Oh yeah, that game. I remember that.
See you,
so they're actual cases with map of London with locations on it. If you look closely, you can see numbers.
Nice.
Phone directory. So if you have a name, you can look up where they live.
Oh, excellent.
And in each book, there's locations, and if you go there, that's the clue you get.
Oh,
so you're basically trying to figure out who done it as a group as one person. You can only play it 10 times, though.
Yeah.
That's the only drawback.
That's available for Tabletop Sim, which, if anybody's interested, actually, is 50% off at the moment.
Ooh. So is this available for Tabletop Sim?
I need to see if it is.
I hope so.
Be nice if it is.
Probably not, because I don't know. Might not be not. If it is, I'm interested in it if it has the expansion cases.
Hmm. Also, Time Stories would be a thing.
Yeah.
Oh, and speaking of Tabletop Simulator, Uno has been trying to get together some people to play Imperial Assault on there for a bit. I know, Kiba's interested.
Red, it is. Red, it is there.
It is?
Sherlock Holmes Consulting.
Okay, Consulting Detective. Does it have the expansions?
Hang on.
Because there's
if anyone else fancies a tactical war game.
Oh, it's also only case 1.
Oh.
So far.
Okay, that's fine. No, I've already finished case 1.
They'll probably add more.
So if anyone else is interested in playing Imperial Assault, then give us a shout.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is Imperial Assault?
It's a tactical Star Wars game on a board where you play as like a little team of rebels, and the other player controls the Imperials, and you like fight your way through the levels and stuff, and you sort of build the levels are built up from a big sort of collection of tiles and things.
Mordheim like.
So is it like Hero
kind
Quest?
Of?
Sort of. Are we still alive, by the way?
It's anywhere near Mordheim, then sold. I'm in. I want it. Put it in my
is
body
Mordheim
and my eyes.
Is Mordheim slot-based or individual character-based? Because it's like you control one unit. It's like a MOBA.
It's one character levels up, gets items.
Yeah, exactly that then.
But you control a squad of singular characters.
So we each get one character in Imperial
okay.
Assault.
Yeah, but I don't care if it's we get a bunch of squads or we get one person each.
Yeah, it's like that. And then presumably Uno would be playing the Imperials and we'd be playing the Rebels.
Okay. In that case, I think we could completely, fully quit until we start deviating into all kinds of discussions.
Yeah. But yes,
I've got some deviations.
Yeah, hit us up if you fancy any tabletop sim games, because I've been playing with Lamb Mower, Runico, and Hub King, and we've been playing Pandemic Legacy, which has been great.
How did that go, by the way? Just so that you can have that on stream, because we could sadly not see the end of it.
It's up on my YouTube now.
Nice. Oh, so you just locally recorded it instead?
Yeah, I always have local recording running now, so...
Good.
Great.
Good, because then I'm going to watch it, because I was getting heavily invested in that.
In that case, we will see you all in 2 weeks' time.
Yep.
See
Thank you very much for watching. See you
possibly earlier if people are playing things, but...
Yeah.
Bye.
Okay.
Bye.